Welcome back, everybody. We're back here again this afternoon at the gifting spot. Gonna check on the apples and go take a look at that nesting spot I found the other day. Let's take a walk and see what's down here. If you remember from part three, the apple that had been on this tree hadn't been disturbed for 6 days, and it was right there, stuck onto that little nub of a branch, right next to this tree that's been shredded with all the bark gone off of it. Well, as you can see, the apple's gone today. I think we're gonna go a little farther back before we put out any fresh apples, and I've got a better idea today for something to try. I've cored out the apple and I'm gonna run a string through it and hang it from the tree. That kind of alleviates the thought out of my mind that it might be something like a raccoon or possum or something that could get up to get to it. So if it's hanging from a string off of a limb, something has got to reach up with a hand to take it down. Here's the spot that's always had the apples taken from it. Looks completely different in some regards back here today. A lot of the tree vines and stuff look like they've been woven and twisted around in a different manner than they were before. Take the camera and let me mess with this for just a minute. here's our first setup. Something would have to be quite the little acrobat to be able to get that. It's up probably a good 7 foot in the air, hanging from a string off of the vine. So maybe that will alleviate the thought of it being a raccoon or a possum or some kind of small animal climbing up there to get them down.
Not so much a structure, but this has been broken and laid across. That wasn't there. And that line.
Laid across, and that's all twisted around into that. Yeah. That's different. We might have to break this into a couple of parts today because we're going to spend some time back here looking at some different areas. Days, so all of this has changed around again. And that one is placed in the tree, and there's not a stump at the bottom where that's broke off. That's actually been placed up through there. To check this out, it's kind of like the guardian of the woods back here. There, that'll give you an idea to the size of it. Wave to the people. She can't hear me. She's more deaf than I am.
What'd you say?
I said wave to the people,
oh,
but you missed it.
He's watching me like that, mm-hmm.
Today we're going to go back there into that woolly bully.
Scary.
ever do it while we're out here with the camera running. First time we were out here, it sounded like two owls talking to each other, but you could tell that they weren't owls because it just didn't sound like a real owl.
And it was even earlier in the day.
By the way, I want to say thanks to Jason for the technical tip with the camera. I appreciate it.